إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My brothers and sisters in Islam, قال الله تعالى وكذلك مكنا ليوسف في الأرض يتبوأ منها حيث يشاء نصيب برحمتنا من نشاء ولا نضيع أجر المحسنين. الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying in Surah Yusuf, the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, and thus we did give Yusuf authority in the land. Yusuf the immigrant, Yusuf the Muslim, we given him authority in the non-Muslim land of Egypt. We established him. We made him empowered in a land where they do not believe in Allah. يتبوأ منها حيث يشاء. Instead of the cell that he was in it, he actually became Al-Aziz. Wherever he wanna go. نصيب برحمتنا من نشاء ولا نضيع أجر المحسنين. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted Yusuf this Al-Ihsan? He was a muhsin. مكن في الأرض بالإحسان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empowered him in the land because of an aspect in our religion is called al-ihsan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, superpowers invade other countries, kill people there to be empowered by force. But Yusuf, a one-man show, he was a Muslim.
in that land of no Islam. And because of that attribute of al-ihsan, he became empowered. التمكين هو الشغل الشاغل لكل فئة في الأرض. Every group of people, they are seeking to be empowered. Everybody. Non-Muslims, Muslims, everyone. But in this verse, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is letting you know the best weapon, if I may use the word, to use to be empowered in the land is to be a muhsin. Because if you are a muhsin, you will capture the hearts. Your enemies will love you. And if they love you, it's over. Actually, the same exact thing was repeated so often in the surah. Whether literally, whether in reference, إيحاءً, to a situation that Yusuf dealt with it in a manner of ihsan. Here is some. ولما بلغ أشده آتيناه حكما وعلما وكذلك نجزي المحسنين. And when he reached his manhood, Yusuf, his full strength, we bestowed upon him knowledge and wisdom. Why? Because he was a muhsin. حتى في السجن. Even in jail. ودخل معه السجن فتيان قال أحدهما إني أراني أعصر خمرا وقال الآخر إني أراني أحمل فوق رأسي خبزا تأكل الطير منه نبئنا بتأويله إنا نراك من المحسنين. His inmates in jail. Each one of them saw a dream. They came to him. Tell us, Yusuf, the interpretation of our dreams. Why did we come to you? Why you? You're a muhsin. We see you muhsin. You're different. We like you. We feel comfortable talking to you. حتى إخوته أو إخوته. Even his own brothers. الذين أجمعوا على أن يجعلوه في غيابة الجب. The one who actually cast him, thrown him in the depth of darknesses in a well to get rid of him. Later on, they did not know who he is. When he took away Binyamin from them, قالوا يا أيها العزيز إن له أبا شيخا كبيرا فخذ أحدنا مكانه إنا نراك من المحسنين ولا يعلمون أنه يوسف. They do not know that this is Yusuf. They do not know that this is Yusuf. When he took Binyamin away from them, they said, please, we promised our father to go back with Binyamin. Please, take one of us, release Binyamin, let us take him back to his father. And we're making this request because we see you muhsin. You're muhsin. And at the end, when they discovered that this is Yusuf, إِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُف. You are Yusuf. قَالَ أَنَا يُوسُف. I am Yusuf. وَهَذَا أَخِي. This is my brother. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has empowered us in earth. Why? إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Again, the same thing. So, what this ihsan that we must have as Muslims in order to be empowered in order to be granted some status in this land. We are immigrants too. Even if you were born here, you migrated. You migrated from Jahiliyyah to Islam. We're all immigrants, one way or another. What is Al-Ihsan? Al-Ihsan, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the highest level of the religion. The highest level of this deen. And this word, you cannot give it an English. If you're an English speaking, or if you read the meanings of the Quran in English, you will find it almost good doing. Absolutely not. Yeah, it's good doing, it's part of it, but this is not al-ihsan. It is not. It is a term that you have to explain, that the English language does not have an equivalent to give it its rich meanings. But here it is. Listen carefully to this. Al-Ihsan is to strive for excellence, to strive to do the best that you can do, you, according to your capacity. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعة. According to your capacity, in all the areas of your life. Again, al-ihsan, that you strive to do your best. You strive for excellence according to your capacity. You do not spare any efforts. You do not. You ask, what does Allah want me to do with this situation? What does Allah want me to do? I'm going to do it to the best of my capacity. In any situation. With this, brothers and sisters in Islam, al-ihsan is like water that seeps into every corner of your lives. It's like a color that you color everything that you do with. You know, imagine water. Imagine cracks in the ground. Al-Ihsan is the water. The cracks are the different sides of your lives. You need to get water there. That would include your relationship with Allah. And this is what, listen carefully to this. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given to Jibreel to define al-ihsan with. Hadith Jibreel al-Ma'roof fi al-Bukhari wa Muslim, Umar ibn Khattab wa Abi Huraira, and other narrators of this hadith. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked by Jibreel, Ya Muhammad, wama al-ihsan? What is al-ihsan? Akhbirni an al-ihsan. Can you define al-ihsan for me? Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-ihsanu an ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tarah. Wa fi riwayat Muslim, an takhsha Allah ka'annaka tarah. Fa in lam takun tarahu فإنه يراك. هذا هو الإحسان. As Allah sees, basically the bottom line is Allah sees and hears, sees what you do, hears what you say at all times. هذا هو الإحسان in your relationship with Allah. إحسان. Listen to this meaning in that story. في معجم الطبراني الكبير حديث زيد بن أسلم that عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما ومولاه نافع they went to the desert in Mecca فعرسوا يعني they wanted to spend a nomad night a nomadic night, just to sleep in the desert. Right towards the end of the day, a shepherd is coming down from the mountains, from the top of the hill, and he has his flocks in front of him. Abdullah ibn Umar went to him and he said, "Ara'i ghanamun ant?" Are you a shepherd? He said, "Yes." قال بعني شاة. Sell to me one of your sheep. قال إني مملوك وإني مؤتمن. I'm a slave and I'm entrusted with this. This is the property of my master. Abdullah ibn Umar wanted to test him. قال بعني شاة. Sell a sheep to me until your master, the wolf, ate it. Look what the slave said. وَأَيْنَ اللَّهِ. Where is Allah? Where is Allah? Huh? I do this, but Allah is... In the morning, Abdullah ibn Umar, by the way, the whole night, weeping and crying, وَأَيْنَ اللَّهِ. وَأَيْنَ اللَّهِ. وَأَيْنَ اللَّهِ. In the morning, he actually inquired, who is this slave? He purchased him. And he purchased the flock. He freed the slave and given him the flocks. قيل أنه أعتق ألف عبد من العبودية. Abdullah ibn Umar. He freed 1,000 slaves from slavery. And he was so known that to the extent that the slaves would come around him and act like they're praying, because he would only free the righteous and the pious of them. They come maybe and acting sometimes like they're praying. And then Zaid would tell him, Ya Abdullah, Ya ibn Umar, they are يخدعونك. They are trying to deceive you. قال من خدعنا في الله خدعنا له. If you deceive me, I will still free them. فهذا هو المعنى. إحسان, once it comes to you, consciousness of Allah, that you know that Allah sees you. And this is, by the way, the thing that Luqman wanted to give to his son. Can you imagine bringing forth generations of Muslims who have that? Huh? They have that consciousness of Allah. You do not need to run. You do not need to go and check out their Facebook and their you do not need to inquire where they are going. You do not need that. You do not need that. Because Ayn Allah, for them is Ayn Allah. You know the famous story that you all know. Umar bin Khattab used to spend, as Amir al-Mu'mineen, being the Amir of the Muslims, during his reign, he used to spend 2/3 of the night just going around and checking on his ra'iyah, the people who are under his custody, the people for whom he is responsible. He heard this conversation between a mother and her daughter. The mother is asking the daughter to mix the milk with water. You know, if you mix the milk with water, you get more milk. And then the daughter tells the mother, Ya Umma, mother, لقد نهانا أمير المؤمنين عن ذلك. Umar banned us from doing this. You don't remember that? Umar said, do not mix the water with milk. Then the mother tells the daughter, Umar is not here. Umar is not here. You know what the daughter said? But the Lord of Umar is here. Hadi, the ancestor of the grandmother of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. That's هذا هو الإحسان. الإحسان. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa and Harun to go to the Pharaoh, اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to the Pharaoh. He has transgressed. فقولا له قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. Speak to him leniently so that he may heed. قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّا نَخَافُ أَن يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا أَوْ أَن يَطْغَى. We're afraid, oh Allah, that he will transgress, he will kill us. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَ. Fear not. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا. I'm with you. أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I hear and I see. Don't worry, go. The story progressed. Sayyidina Musa went out with the children of Israel. They are approaching the Red Sea. The Pharaoh broke his promise. And he is trying to catch up with them to kill them. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. When they are about, Bani Israel, they said to Musa, Musa, they are going to get to us. Look. قَالَ كَلَّا. No. إِنَّ مَعِيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. My Lord is with me. He will guide me. He will tell me what to do. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى أَنْ اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرَ فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Strike the sea with your stick, you will have a bridge. The same concept when Abu Bakr said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, في الغار, in the cave, Wallahi, if they look down, they will see us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, Ya Aba Bakr, ma dhannuka bithnain, Allahu thalithuhuma. If you can produce a generation like this, but this requires education, educating our children about the names and the attributes of Allah. Tawheed, not as a curriculum, Tawheed in action. When you teach math, you're teaching them Tawheed. When you teach science, you're teaching them Tawheed. When you teach language arts, you're teaching them Tawheed. You color everything with Tawheed. To be able to produce that. Not just statements that you make. Not just a lesson plan that you create. No. It's everything together. But with this, brothers and sisters in Islam, comes home, the house as well. But this is the first area. Your relationship with Allah. Your ibadah. Look, ihsan. في الإسلام إحسان in your Islam. How? The quality of your ibadah, and that you do more than what you're asked to do. Look at this. Look at هذه الآيات في سورة الذاريات. إن المتقين في جنات وعيون. Indeed the righteous people will be granted gardens and springs. Why do they get this in the day of resurrection? Why? آخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. They are taking joy in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted them. Why? إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ. They used to be muhsin in the dunya. How? كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. They hardly sleep at night. By the way, you could pray 5 times and sleep. Just 5 times and sleep. هذا هو المينيمم. But الإحسان is لا. He hardly sleeps at night. كانوا قليلا. You see, الإسلام is the 5 daily prayers. But الإحسان is more. نوافل, تهجد. Not only this. يعني وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. حسن البصري يقول سبحان الله مكثوا الليل يصلون وفي الصباح يستغفرون وقبل السحر يستغفرون. They spend the whole night praying and then before Fajr they sit and say أستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر الله. كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. اسمع إلى هذه النكتة. Listen. وفي أموالهم حق للسائل والمحروم. قارن بين هذه. Compare this وبين سائل سائل. سورة المعارج. Allah said, وفي أموالهم حق معلوم. A fixed right, which is the 2.5%. But al-ihsan, once it comes to your money, if you're a muhsin, you believe all of your money belongs to the poor. وفي أموالهم حق للسائل والمحروم. Their wealth is a right to the poor and the مساكين. But في سورة المعارج, سورة المعارج it talks about the Muslims. حق معلوم, a fixed amount, which is the 2.5%. وهكذا, you apply this. الصيام, not just Ramadan, عاشوراء, the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, Monday and Thursday, the 3 years out of the month. إحسان, هكذا. إحسان في العبادة. This is two. Here is the most important piece, and this is how Yusuf got empowered. الإحسان إلى الغير. إحسان to other people, to the people. You see, your relationship with Allah is between you and Allah. Your ibadah is between you and Allah. But this peace is what will present you to the people. Ihsan to the people. What is ihsan in your relationship to the people? To say the least, الصبر الجميل والصفح الجميل والهجر الجميل. Beautiful patience. People harm you. People slander you. People gossip about you. People do all type of things to you. But you have something called beautiful patience. وهذا ما قاله يعقوب. فصبر جميل. What is a صبر الجميل؟ ألا تشتكي أحد إلى أحد من الناس. That you do not complain about what you're going through to other person. Patience. You don't nag. يا أخي سبحان الله, their brothers threw him in the well. The wife of Al-Aziz got to him. He went to jail. Wallahi ما سمعنا. I never read anything in Surah Yusuf where he complained. Oh, my brothers just threw me in the well. Oh, my brothers did this. Oh, my, the wife. لا, صبر جميل. What is صبر جميل? إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. That I complain only to Allah. هذا هو الصبر الجميل. But you don't call yourself patient if you go, oh, the brothers are backbiting me. Oh, they are gossiping me about me. Oh, they are slandering me. Oh, هذا ليس بالصبر. This is صبر. Yeah, you not taking a hit back. But this is not a beautiful patience. صبر الجميل. Two, الصفح الجميل. A beautiful forgiveness. What is a beautiful forgiveness? That people harm you and you return their harm with forgiveness. وما هو beautiful forgiveness? الذي لا عتاب فيه. That you don't even mention what they did to you. The brothers of Yusuf later on, they get, وَاللَّهِ, by Allah, لَقَدْ آثَرَكَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَإِنْ كُنَّا لَخَاطِئِينَ. By Allah, Allah has preferred you over us, Ya Yusuf. And we were wrong, Ya Yusuf. What did he say to them? قَالَ لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ. Forget it. We're okay. We're cool. We're good. Let's just move on. Done. Don't talk about it. Don't talk about it. صفح الجميل. Beautiful forgiveness. That you don't, oh, I'll forgive you, but remember, you did this and this and this and this and this. هذا ليس صفح جميل. This is not beautiful patience. Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful forgiveness. Yeah, نعم. It's forgiveness, but not beautiful. لا, ألا تعاتب. ألا تعاتب. Again, can we produce a generation like this? Huh? Can we? The culture out there is teaching our children that to be cool, you need to hit back. You need to vengeance, to obtain vengeance. You need to strike back. You need to yell out. That's the culture. That's what they are teaching them in television, in soap operas, in public schools. That's what they are teaching them. What did the Prophet ﷺ say about this? Huh? What did he say about this? لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالسُّرْعَةِ The strong is not the one who yells loud or the one who beats everybody down. وَلَكِنَّ الشَّدِيدَ مَنْ يَمْلِكْ نَفْسَهُ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ But the strong person is the one who contains himself when he gets angry. This is the real strength. صفح الجميل الهجر الجميل خلاص If you cannot fix it فهجرهم هجرا وهجرهم هجرا جميلا Beautiful what? Like Ibrahim كده لما قال لأبيه سلام عليك سأستغفر لك ربي سلام عليك my father is not working between us سلام peace please I live in peace. خلاص. If it's not working between us, خلاص. يعني, no problem. May Allah forgive you and forgive me. Salam. هذا هو. إحسان. To say the least, if somebody hit you here, you tell him, please. Go ahead. هذا هو الإحسان. طيب. ده حتى يعني سبحان الله إن الله كتب الإحسان حديث أبي يعلى شداد بن أوس في صحيح مسلم إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء وكتب عند أكثر الأصوليين تعني الوجوب وفيه نظر يعني تنزل للمندوب أحيانا بس لفظ كتب لك يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا كتب يعني فرض يأثم من لا يأتي به the word كتب means it's mandatory إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء الله prescribed إحسان in everything that you do فإذا قتلتم فأحسنوا القتلة وإذا ذبحتم فأحسنوا الذبحة وليحدد أحدكم شفرته وليرح ذبيحته Even with the animals يا الله إحسان with the animals هذه المرأة This woman who went to Jannah who used to be a prostitute She was walking in the desert She found a deep well She was so thirsty She went back and got a drink. She climbing up. She saw a dog licking the sand from thirst. قالت والله by Allah لقد أصاب هذا الكلب ما أصابني. This dog is going through what I went through. Look what she did. She went back down to the well, the deep well. She takes off her shoes. She fills it with water. She places the shoe in her mouth because she has to climb. You see, she did some efforts. She did efforts to do this. It was not easy. Take a drink. La. She went down, put the shoes in her mouth. Does she have to do this? هذا إحسان. هذا إحسان للكلب. Imagine if you do إحسان to a كلب. This is what you get. What about إحسان to a human being? To someone who is موحد. Huh? موحد a Muslim إحسان هذا الحديث يعني لا يفهم أن أنت يعني you go and prostitute and then you come give drinks to dogs I hope that's not what you understand it but you see this woman Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided her to repentance from that day on she repented and she became a good person and she died as a good person هكذا فهذا هو الإحسان 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 أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في سورة القصص spoke about the children of Israel being oppressed in Egypt, who were the Muslims at the time, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to empower them. ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين ونمكن لهم في الأرض. We want to give them authority. We want to establish them in the land. Then Allah said, let's begin with the new generation. Let's bring forth another generation. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضَهِ. If we are brothers and sisters in Islam to come out of our status now, our condition, we must think likewise. Not only to bring a new generation into this world, but to teach them al-ihsan. It's going to take a while. It is an effort. It is not a one-day effort. But at least you're contributing to the welfare of the ummah. For this reason, the brothers who are working on the high school initiative, we decided to call the school Al-Ihsan Academy. Because that's what we want to strive to produce. We want a new generation that has ihsan once it comes to Allah, has ihsan once it comes to their ibadah, has ihsan once it comes to the relationship with the other people, has ihsan once it comes to the animals, to the trees, and you know what? Have ihsan once it comes to language art, science, and math. You know, another thing that was a given to Yusuf, another thing that he excelled in his work too. When Egypt was confronted with that drought, Yusuf presented the feasibility plan, the feasibility study to save the country. تزرعون سبع سنين دأبا فما حصدتم فذروه في سنبله إلا قليلا مما تأكلون ثم يأتي من بعد ذلك سبع شداد يأكلن ما قدمتم لهن إلا قليلا مما تحصنون ثم يأتي من بعد ذلك عام فيه يغاث الناس وفيه يعصرون. He excelled. Don't you dare think that I just want to take our children to the stone era. Absolutely not. You know what? We are a part of America. We live here. We live here. We must contribute to the welfare of this community. We must strive to produce gurus in science, language art, math. But not at the expense of our deen. Absolutely not. Not the expense of our akhirah. Absolutely not. No. 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 Don't do it. No. Haram. Not. This is why Al-Ihsan Academy is here. I'm calling upon all the community to show up on Sunday, the day after tomorrow, May 22nd. We're going to present the actual initiative. The purpose, the objective of that meeting is to hear you. We've been doing some
initial work, we'll present it to you. We want to hear your feedback. Take your feedback, incorporate it. Again, I want to let you know, this is a community initiative. It's not a one-man show. A community initiative. Our community needs it. Please, please help us out. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتناب. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين. اللهم وفقنا إلى ما تحب وترضى. اللهم وفقنا إلى ما تحب وترضى. اللهم خذ بنواصينا إلى الخير.